Welcome back. So in this tutorial we will be learning the rest machining and toolpath statistics. So let's start. So at first we will import a model. Right click on model, import model, then EG, and suppose I use a die model. Then plane shade, isometric view. Okay, so rest machining is basically you use a larger tool to remove the large amount of material, and after that you use a smaller tool to remove the whatever material is left by the smaller tool. So that gives you advantage of time saving. So at first we will create a larger tool. Create a tool, suppose tip radius. So we want a tool of 30 diameter, 5 radius, tip radius of 5. Then close. Then we want to create a machining using this toolpath strategies. Go to toolpath strategies, 3D area clearance, offset area clear. Okay. So in this, we want to keep a thickness of suppose 0.2 for the finishing. Then step 4 tool is of 30, so step 4 we will give up 25. So this is a roughening, so we will set up as a name. Then step 4, step down we will use up 2 mm. Okay, then we will apply this toolpath. Okay, before applying toolpath we have to define the block, so we will define the block, calculate, we will define a fit block, accept, then we will say apply. So this toolpath is created, we will cancel this. So this toolpath with 30 tool diameter is created. So after this 30 tool we want to run a tool of 10, end mill of 10 diameter. So we will create one end mill of 10 diameter, close. Then we will create one more toolpath, offset area clear. So in this now end mill we are using, so thickness will be 0.2 only. We will make the step 4 of 8, we will keep step down of 2. So this is a rest toolpath, so we will say it rest. Then we want to do a rest machining, so we will tick here, I want to do rest machining. Then a reference toolpath you have to define, which toolpath you want to, so I want to refer the rough. So here detect metal thicker than, you can define. So whatever number you put here, so it will machine the material greater than that value. So you can leave some material if you want. If you say 0.2, so it will machine the material whose thickness is greater than 0.2. So in that way you can use it, and expand area by, so it is useful. So whatever your rest toolpath is created, that will be expanded by that dimension if required. So it will expand that complete toolpath by that much direction. So in that way you can use expand area by, then just say apply. So in this way this toolpath is created. So we will just say cancel. So this rest toolpath is created. So we can see how it works by using the simulation. We just plan it. So we will say view mill on. We will take the at first roughening toolpath, then run. So it is showing the larger tool machining. So we will increase the speed. So this is a larger tool. Machining is done by larger tool. So larger tool machining is done, is almost done. Now we will run the rest machining. So we will say rest, run. So it is rest of machining. In rest of machining, it will, the tool will run only in the areas where larger tool was unable to go. So it will basically give a time saving at first. So because larger tool will require lesser time to remove the material. Then second thing, the tool loading on smaller tool will reduce because it will be removing only the remained material. So in this way, the rest machining is useful. So at first you have to use the larger tool, then use the smaller tool to remove the remaining material. So that is the rest machining. So we will come out, exit VML. Yes, alt. Then we can take the judgment of what time is required for each toolpath by right click on the toolpath and just say, just activate the toolpath for which you want to see the time judgment. Then right click. Once I activated, then right click and say statistics. So here you can view, it is showing the lead links time and cutting moves time. So lead links is time in the air when tools are in air, rapid plunge, wrap, other different movements, what is the time required, and what is the total time in the air. Then you can see cutting moves, linear cutting moves, arc continuous, what is the time required, and how many times to lift. That detail is also given here, and you can also see what is the total time required. So in this way, you can see the time. Basically CNC machining is, you should need a lesser time and lesser tool loads. So you can take the time judgment from here. So in this way, you can use rest machining and you can view the statistics. So thanks for joining. We will stop here.